Hello everyone, this is Tim with Online Big Blue, bringing you the best in New York Giants sports talk and entertainment. Ooh, season's gonna be here soon. Looks like we're kicking off mañana. Which will be fun, which will be interesting, which will be good. Gonna watch the game, of course, like everyone else on the planet, I hope. Just a couple quick housekeeping moves with the Giants. The Giants did make two practice squad moves. They signed defensive back Ryan Lewis and running back Rod Smith. They were both added to the practice squad, and Derek Dillon was removed at least for now. Rod Smith, I think you probably all remember, is a running back from the Cowboys. Spent 3.5 years with old Jason Garrett. Had a cup of coffee with the Giants in the preseason. Didn't make the team. Got injured. We moved on. You know what? He can play. He can play both running back and fullback, so you know what? He's a good guy to have around. Lewis, I don't know much about Lewis. I know he was 8 games with Miami, 3 which he started. He played with Patrick Graham. He's 6 feet, 185 pounds, undrafted free agent out of Pitt. You know what? Two good signings, a good depth at running back and good depth over at the cornerback as well. One thing I wanted to talk about today is Saquon Barkley. And again, this is going to sound like an idiotic statement because in some ways it is an idiotic statement. But Saquon Barkley, at least in my mind in week one, needs to move into the forefront of the offense. And I mean he needs to be the complete focal point of the offense. Why? I'm not 100% sold on our offensive line whatsoever. I am worried about Cam Fleming. I'm worried about Thomas. I'm worried about Gates or potentially Pulley over in the center position. Kevin, I'm not worried about. Will Hernandez, I have some trepidation about as well, only because of the fact that he has had a bad second year. I mean, like I said, we can't gauge what our team looks like off of this training camp because, to be perfectly honest, without any type of preseason, we have no idea. And I've said it before, if the offensive line is this bad or the defensive line is this good, or if they're both terrible or if they're both fantastic, we have no idea. For Daniel Jones to survive the Pittsburgh game, and Pittsburgh has a top 10 defense, and Pittsburgh has tons of veterans on this defense, so they potentially have the ability to confuse Andrew Thomas, to confuse Nick Gates if he's getting his first start at center, to confuse Cam Fleming. And you know what? For Daniel Jones to survive this game, we need to go Barkley left, Barkley right, Barkley out of the backfield. And I mean, we have to be a run-heavy oriented team, and that's probably why we are carrying all the tight ends coming out of training camp. We need to just go I formation, put him 7 yards in the backfield, line up Penny in front of him, and just deliver the mail. Plow the road. I can't think of any other cliches off the top of my head, but I will try to think of some later. And just try to ram it down the Pittsburgh front seven. Now, the problem with that is Pittsburgh is probably going to put 7 in the box. They're probably going to stack. I mean, they may put 8 in the box. I mean, so they are going to dare. And I guarantee you, the first 3 series, they are going to dare Daniel Jones to throw. They are going to go probably man-to-man, single coverage, and like I said, and just stack the line. And I get concerned in some ways because they're also their defensive backfield in Pittsburgh is pretty good. So I get concerned that if we are put in a situation where we are going to pass and our line starts to leak, that poor Daniel Jones is going to get wrecked. And yes, he's got some speed. He's got some wheels. But it doesn't mean he's not Michael Vick. You know, he's not Lamar Jackson. You know, he's not even Pat White. Again, going back old school to Miami for Patrick Graham. He's got the moves, but the thing is, we do not want our franchise quarterback running. And the thing is also, we need to make sure that Daniel Jones is developing pocket presence, pocket awareness. His first instinct, if the line starts collapsing, should not be to run. It should be to do an Eli. move to the left, move to the right, step up into the pocket, step back, you know, roll out. I see a lot of, if I'm handicapping this, I am going to see a lot, I think we are going to see a lot of planned rollouts from Jason Garrett, get Daniel Jones outside the box and get him off to the sidelines and see if he can't make a play throwing downfield, or see if he can't make a play out of the backfield, or see if he can't just make a play running the ball, running with his own feet. But the thing is, we need to focus on Saquon Barkley. And I mean, we this week especially, honestly, in the next 3 weeks, we need to go Barkley left, Barkley right, Barkley out of the backfield. And I don't care if they know it's coming. If our line can dominate the run, that's what we need to do. And that's what we are going to need to directly focus on. Because it's, and we've gone through this before, it is a hell of a lot easier to run block than it is to pass block. And I am not filled with joy seeing Daniel Jones going back and having Andrew Thomas, Nick Gates, and Cam Fleming trying to protect him. I'm not filled with joy with that right now. Why? Because I don't know, and nobody knows, how this is going to work out. I mean, you can say you know, but you don't know. Like I said, the opposite is, the pass blocking could be phenomenal. It could be spectacular for all that we know coming into this game. I mean, for all we know, they could be the Dallas line from a couple years ago. You know, we don't know. But to protect our investment, to protect our franchise, we need to protect Daniel Jones. And like I said, my one concern is that Joe Judge decides he wants to try to become the smartest guy in the room and start attacking the Pittsburgh defense with the pass. The problem with this is Pittsburgh is a veteran defense. You're not going to put them on their heels. Mike Tomlin, I watched coach for 2 years in Tampa. He was a defensive backfield coach. I can't say I knew that he was going to be a head coach or be a wonderful head coach when he was with Tampa. But you know what? You could see that he prepared the defensive backfield. And of course, if you have Rondé Barber and everything back there, it's pretty easy to prepare the defensive backfield. But he prepared his defensive backfield. He prepared his guys. They are not going to be, and if you ever watched Pittsburgh play over the last, you know, 7 years, they are not going to be stunned by anything that the Giants are going to throw at them. People are not shaking in their boots right now of receiving core of Golden Tate, Sterling Shepard, and Darius Slayton. Golden Tate's gotten a year older, probably lost a step a little bit. We hope he hasn't. And then you have Sterling Shepard, who's always one play away from concussion protocol. And then you have our old buddy Darius Slayton, who we are hoping is going to make the adjustments needed in year two to not succumb to the sophomore slump. And those are the things that we're kind of hoping they're kind of going to focus on. So like I said, I also want to see Wayne Gallman get in the mix. I want to see these, like I said, I want to see 4 yards a carry. I want to see an average of 4 yards a carry from this Giant backfield. Now, we had some problems running last year, and we had some problem, you know, like I said, but that was a different line. We've revamped the line again outside of Williams and Zeidler. Or excuse me, not Williams, Hernandez and Zeidler. So we have revamped the line again. And like I said, I'm hoping this is going to be a precursor for the entire season that we just jam the ball down teams' throats. Because like I said, I think that's the reason why we're carrying so many tight ends. You know, I mean, we got the guy out of Pittsburgh. I mean, we got the guy out of San Francisco who's 7 feet, 9 inches tall and 400 pounds. He's like an extra offensive lineman. I don't want him catching the ball. I want him running the ball down the throat. Now, of course, if that starts working, I 100% want to see Daniel Jones in the play action. I want to see Daniel Jones tucking and hiding that ball. I hope he was working on his play action, selling his play action pass. I really do hope he was working on that because it was not the best last year, and I would not expect it to be the best last year because he's a rookie. But hopefully he's maturated enough this year that it's going to be a little bit better. Hopefully he learned from Eli. Eli had a nice play action pass, especially not. And I want people to stop thinking of Eli the last 3 years. I want people to start thinking how Eli was 7 or 8 years ago. You know, he could sell the play action pass extremely well. That's why he was very effective when we had the earth, wind, and fire running backs. You know, another good part, like Phil Sims was another good giant guy with able to sell the play action pass. Why? Because of the fact, especially in the 80s, he had Joe Morris, you know, Rodney Hampton. He had Maurice Carthon, as the fullback. So you know what the Giants, what they did? They ran the ball down the throat of other teams. So it was easier to sell the play action pass that way when you have that ability. So like I said, I hope that Barkley can just, I hope we can just focus on the running game. And like I said, I want the key component the next 3 weeks to be Saquon Barkley. I want Barkley in the forefront, kind of like the thumbnail, and Daniel Jones to kind of be in the background, kind of be in the shadow. And I, like I said, if Daniel Jones only threw the ball 20 times a game, 20 times, if Daniel Jones only throws the ball 20 times against Pittsburgh, I will tell you this, we will win the game. Because that's telling me that our offense is keeping Pittsburgh's offense off the field. And that's what we need to do. We need to manage the clock. We need to go old school Giants. We need to go the Giants of the early 80s. We need to go the Giants even in the 90s. We need earth, wind, and fire. You know, we need that big running back. We need, like I said, we need the Joe Morris. We need the Rodney Hamptons. You know, we just need something that's going to be able to move the chains and move the sticks. I mean, I'll even take an O.J. Anderson, like against Buffalo. Just run the ball. I loved it because I remember when Hampton got hurt and Anderson had to start the Super Bowl season. I laughed because Parcells had it was the first couple games of the season. Anderson broke off a big run for a touchdown. It was like 30, 40 yards. And Parcells looked at him on the sideline and Parcells said to him, you know what? With that hole, I could have broke off 30. And that's what I want to see. I want to see the line open up big holes that even I could break off 30 yards. That's what I want to see for the Giants in Pittsburgh, and I think we will. And again, this is Tim with Online Big Blue, bringing you the best in New York Giants sports talk entertainment. If you want, just drop us an email at onlinebigblue@gmail.com or follow us on Twitter at onlinebigblue1@twitter.com. And you know what? We are getting closer and closer and closer to, you know, to not only the kickoff, but to the Giants opening kickoff. And I think that's what we all care about a little bit more right now. And again, this is Tim with Online Big Blue, bringing you the best in New York Giants sports talk entertainment. And as always, if you could like, if you could subscribe, if you could ring that bell, you know what that means? That'd be awesome.